Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making fresh strawberry mousse. And in Kentucky, strawberries are in season and they're not very expensive, so I thought that would be perfect for today's recipe. I wanted to show you that my peonies are blooming. They're not in full bloom, but a few of them were ready, so I thought I'd just share them with you since I've shown you so much of my herb garden and landscaping and so on. But for these strawberries, you'll need a pint. This is like 2 cups that are heaping. So we're going to put these into a large bowl and mash them. You notice I have them quartered already. That's just to make it a little easier to mash. It's kind of hard to mash whole berries. So I'll take care of that with a fork and be back soon. This is the way your strawberries look after you have mashed them. It doesn't take much work. If you want to use a blender, you may, but don't puree them. Have some chunks of strawberry in them. That would be much nicer. Once you get them mashed, then you need to separate the juice from the berries. So you can take a strainer like this and then pour your strawberry mixture in. Let the juice go through, and it won't go through readily, but you'll take a fork or spoon and mash the berries until you can get as much juice as possible in your measuring cup. You need to reserve that juice. Here's what your strawberries look like after you have strained them and gotten as much juice as possible. It's still yielding a little bit of juice, but most of the strawberry juice is over here in a measuring cup because we're going to use it. Now I need to pour water in until we have 1.5 cups of liquid. So I have some water sitting here and had just about the right amount. Now this liquid I'm going to put in a pot and take that to the stove. So we're just going to pour that in. That's nice strawberry juice with water. All I have to do is bring this to a boil. Use medium-high heat, we'll be fine, and just when it comes to a boil, we'll be back over there. My strawberry juice and water mixture has come to a boil, and here it is. My strawberries are still giving a little bit of juice, which I will use later on, but the strawberries themselves I'm going to set aside while I work with the strawberry juice and water. I have a large package of jell-O, and this is sugar-free variety. You may use the kind with sugar if you prefer, but use a large box. And put in the granules. Just stir until it's dissolved. And then the next step will be to place it in the refrigerator just to cool. Don't let it gel up, but when it's cool, then you can continue the recipe. Now that our jell-O mixture is chilling in the refrigerator, it's a good time for us to whip some cream. You need 1.5 cups of heavy whipping cream. So I'm just putting that in a medium-sized bowl, and I'm going to use an electric mixer to whip this until soft peaks form and then go a little beyond that. Here's the whipped cream, and you can see that it holds its shape, but the peaks are not very stiff. They're kind of soft. That's the way you want it. Now, I got my jell-O mixture out of the refrigerator. You can see it's almost beginning to gel a little bit. But that's what you want it. You want it on the verge of gelling. You want it very cold. I put the strawberries back in the refrigerator so that they would be cold as well. There's a little bit of juice there. That's fine. It'll just go with the other juice when these eventually get combined. But I'm going to put the strawberry pulp back in the bowl. To the chilled strawberry pulp, I'm going to add 1/4 cup white sugar. You can use your fork or you can get a spoon at this point if you like. Just get those together and then those get reunited with the juice, which has jell-O in it as well. So into the pot and stir that around. Now we're going to fold the whipped cream into our mixture of sugared berries and the gelatin mixture. Now you need to be gentle in this folding motion. Go under and then bring it over the top. And keep doing that until you have a nice mixture where no white streaks show. So this is what our mousse is going to be like. Now, typically for a mousse, what you would do at this point is pour this into a mold. So if you have a nice mold that you'd like to use, you might want to spray it with cooking oil spray first so that this will release very easily. But I don't really have any that are appropriate for this time of year. I have holiday ones. So I decided to do it a different way, which is even easier and is guaranteed to come out well. Because if your mold doesn't unmold, you're really in trouble with the mousse. But I've decided what type of glass I'm going to use for serving these, and these are just dessert glasses, Sunday glasses, and I'm just going to take a small spoon so I don't really mess them up, and then I'm going to refrigerate it, and these four that I'm making right now, once they're refrigerated, they will gel a bit, or set up, I guess is a better way to put it, and before we serve them, we will decorate the top. Our fresh strawberry mousse has chilled in the refrigerator for about an hour and a half, something like that. And you can see what it looks like. It's firm, and you can tell when you do like this, if it doesn't fall out, then it's pretty well set. This is the point where if you had put it in a mold, you would want to unmold it and go ahead and serve it. Or you could put it back in the refrigerator unmolded, and it would be fine. But I decided to just do the easy way since I didn't really have the mold anyway. And to dress it up a little bit, I've gotten some Cool Whip. This is kind of a creamy style, extra creamy. It's just what I had, but use any kind that you want. You can keep your calories down by getting something that's not so creamy. But I'm just going to put some on top of each one. Let me show you one here. And then I have a fresh washed strawberry that you want to dry with paper toweling, and then that makes a nice topping for it. I'm going to take a taste of the fresh strawberry mousse, so we'll just take this one on the end, and what I want to do is to use a spoon. This is a spoon that can get to the bottom of it. It's an iced teaspoon, and I want to show you the texture, so I'm just going to peel that back a little and go down into it, and you can see what it looks like. Has little specks of strawberry all through it because we saved that when we actually mashed the strawberries and strained out the juice, we made sure that there was plenty of pulp still. So I'm going to take this bite. It's pretty big. Tastes great. It's just like strawberries bursting in your mouth. That is so full of strawberry flavor. You couldn't imagine because it does have a combination of the actual strawberries and then the strawberry jello. So it's got two kinds of strawberries mixing together and they strengthen each other quite a lot. And if you have strawberries available now, you ought to try it because it's very easy to make and you don't have to wait too long to get it done, particularly if you put it in individual containers like this. So I hope you enjoy this recipe and I hope you have a use for it.